What's up, guys? Welcome back to Tenorshare channel. Apple has released iOS 14.5.1 days ago, and has no longer signed iOS 14.5. So, did you upgrade to the latest iOS? If not, please watch this video and check out issues that users from iOS 14.5.1 reported. This can help you decide whether to upgrade or not. Cause they really found that iOS 14.5.1 sucks. Now let's dive in. The first common issue is the battery drain. Some users found that their iPhone get easily ran out of battery after upgrading. This happens especially if you're using the old iPhone but not the 12 series. And also, if you're using Apple Watch. Some users also reported that their watch with the latest watchOS, the battery drained faster than usual, which could not last for the whole day. And the second issue is the Bluetooth connection. This issue is reported by some users who use AirPods to listen music on Spotify. They said when AirPods connected, but Spotify wouldn't play around with them. So far I haven't met this issue with my AirPods Pro. So if you have the same issue like this, leave your comments below to let us know. And the next issue, the third issue, is the scroll stutter. Just found out that many users complained about their apps ran so slow, especially when they're browsing. Some users also reported the keyboard stuck when they're typing. Or when running a game like PUBG, the game dropped frame badly. And we also found that some users have FaceTime issue. The FaceTime call got stuck after completing the call. It just kept returning on the screen FaceTime unavailable, even after force closing the app. Also, some users found out their apps easily got crashing when they closed the app. But apps on my phone worked just fine. Also, leave your comments below if you have the same issue. So far, these issues have been found on iOS 14.5.1. We've also tried some solutions that may help. The first solution is to factory reset your iPhone after upgrading. You can go to Settings, in General. Scroll down to tap on Reset. And choose to erase all content and settings. But this requires you to back up your iPhone before erasing. If you feel like trouble factory resetting, you can also try the next solution. To use Tenorshare ReiBoot to repair your operating system. It won't cause any data loss. So what you need to do is to connect your iPhone to the computer. No need to back up before repairing actually. And on ReiBoot, click on green start button. And choose standard repair without data loss. Go on to download the latest firmware of iPhone, and later the repair process will start. It usually takes about 10 minutes to repair. Sooner your iPhone system will be refreshed, and all the data are still on the phone, and those system issues might not annoy you anymore. Okay, so this is the video about iOS 14.5.1 issue we have found, and the solution we suggested you trying. If any of them helps, don't forget to give us a thumb up. I'll be grateful if you subscribe. Stay tuned for our next video.